The decision to intubate has been made, and now a lot of equipment needs to be prepared. In this video, we'll go over the equipment and a structure that helps you remember what to prepare before the procedure can start. I've found the best way to remember is to divide the equipment into our usual ABCs, and in that way, we can mentally go through the procedure and the associated risks. Starting with A, the airway, we begin with the essentials for smooth, problem-free intubation. We choose a properly sized blade and check the lamp of the laryngoscope. We open up an endotracheal tube that will fit the patient and prepare it with the stylet. We also need a syringe for the cuff of the tube. In the best case scenario, this is all the airway equipment we will use, but quite often things are not so easy. So first we prepare for the situation when the vocal cords are hard to visualize and make sure a video laryngoscope and a bougie is nearby. If mucus or blood is obstructing our view, we need to have a suction catheter prepared. A Magill forceps could also come in handy in those rare cases where something solid is obstructing the airway. If we can't get our tube into place on our first attempts, we're gonna need to bag mask ventilate the patient, and for that we use a bag valve mask with a fitting face mask attached to it. To make mask ventilation easier, we may want to insert an oropharyngeal airway. And if we still can't ventilate or intubate, a laryngeal mask airway can save the situation. If we've optimized our intubation conditions but still can't intubate or in any other way oxygenate the patient, we've reached the end of the difficult airway algorithm and an emergency cricothyrotomy kit should be available. That last part is really a last resort, and of course, a very, very rare occurrence. So let's move on to B and breathing. When the patient is intubated, we want to listen to make sure we hear breathing sounds on both sides of the thorax as a sign that the tube is in the airway and on an adequate depth. To be absolutely sure we're in the trachea, we want to use an end-tidal CO2 device to detect carbon dioxide. If we have a ventilator nearby, we might want to check the settings we want to use for the patient in advance. And now let's move on to C and circulation. This is where we'll check that our patient has adequately sized IV cannulas that work well with sufficient flow for fast volume infusion. We also want to prepare drugs like epinephrine and norepinephrine. When we assess the circulation, we also want to decide whether or not we need and have time to insert an arterial line, which will increase the accuracy of our blood pressure management. Finally, we have D, disability. This is where we think of our analgesics that ensure the laryngoscopy isn't painful. We also choose the hypnotics and muscle relaxants for our patient. When all the equipment is ready, I do a last-minute checklist to make sure I've optimized everything. If you found this valuable, please like and subscribe. And also, if you have other tips to share on the topic, let me know in the comment section.